Hello students, my name is Darshan Sarang. I am working as an assistant professor at S.N. Patel Institute of Technology, Umrakh, Bardoli, Surat. This is our second lecture on the topic Units and Dimension. As we aware that we are student of chemical engineering, so we deal with chemicals, and when it comes to chemicals, it have some chemical formula. So it have some atoms, some molecules, atomic weights, molecule weights, and we measure these concentration of these chemicals in different ways. So before we discuss the measurement method, we will see what is the equivalent weight of a component. In previous lecture, we had seen the molecular weight of the component or compound, how to calculate molecular weight. Here we will calculate the equivalent weight of the component. So from the definition, we can see that it is defined as the ratio of atomic weight or molecular weight of the component to its valency. Now, what is valency? The valency of an element or a compound depends on the number of hydroxyl ion donated or hydrogen ions accepted for atomic weight or molecular weight. So we will take one or two example to know the equivalent weight, how to calculate equivalent weight, or what is valency of the compound. So suppose if we have hydrochloric acid, so this hydrochloric acid is denoted by HCl. So it is actually H plus Cl minus. So one H plus is there and one Cl minus is there. So we can say that the valency of HCl is 1. And the molecular weight, we know how to calculate molecular weight of the HCl. So it will be atomic weight of hydrogen plus atomic weight of chlorine. So it will be the molecular weight. Now the valency is 1. So we can say that for HCl, equivalent weight of HCl is equal to molecular weight of HCl. In another example, we can take sulfuric acid. So the formula for sulfuric acid is H2SO4. So it is actually 2H plus and SO4 minus 2. If we divide H2SO4 into its ions, cations and anions, then it will be 2H plus and SO4 minus 2. So the valency will be 2. So equivalent weight equal to molecular weight of H2SO4 divided by valency of H2SO4. So molecular weight of H2SO4 will be 98 and the valency is 2. So equivalent weight will become 49 in case of H2SO4. Same way in case of H3PO4, that is phosphorus acid, the valency will be 3. So I hope the concept of valency is clear and how to calculate equivalent weight is also understood. Now coming to the main point, the methods of measuring concentration of chemical. The first method is the normality. As we know that in laboratory we have prepared some stock solution or other chemicals. So when we prepared this chemical solution, we measure this chemical in terms of various units like normality, molarity, then molality. Some people use, or in some branch it is formality or also used. So what is normality? So normality is generally denoted by capital N, and it is defined as the number of gram equivalents of the solute dissolved in 1 liter of solution. So for example, for preparation of 1 normal sodium hydroxide solution, we have to dissolve 40 grams of NaOH, or which is equivalent to 1 gram equivalent of NaOH in 1 liter of solution. So now again comes, what is solute, what is solvent, and what is solution. So here we have taken example of NaOH, that is sodium hydroxide. So in our case, sodium hydroxide will be our solute. The water is our solvent, and when this NaOH is mixed in water, it will become solution. So the formula of normality is equal to gram equivalents of solute divided by volume of solution in liter. So volume of solution in liter is suppose known to us, and gram equivalent is equal to gram of solute taken divided by its equivalent weight. In the next slide, we will see the example of how to calculate normality. Now comes to molarity. So molarity is defined as the number of gram moles of solute dissolved in 1 liter of solution, and it is denoted by capital M. So molarity is gram moles of solute divided by volume of solution in liter. Again, our solute is sodium hydroxide, and our solution is the mixture of sodium hydroxide and water. The third method to denote our concentration is molality. So it is defined as the number of gram moles of solute dissolved in 1 kilogram of solvent. So here, what is the difference between molarity and molality? In case of molarity, it was volume of solution, not the mass. And in case of molality, it is the mass of solvent in kilogram. Again, we will see what is normality. It is gram equivalent of solute divided by volume of solution in liter, and molarity is gram moles of solute divided by volume of solution in liter. Here the difference is, we are taking mass of the solvent in kilogram. So these three are the major method to measure the concentration of any compound. So here are the example of equivalent weights, that how to calculate equivalent weights. So as we discussed previously, in case of HCl, we need to calculate the molecular weight of HCl, that is 1 into atomic weight of hydrogen plus 1 into atomic weight of chlorine. So the molecular weight of HCl is 36.5, and when we divided this HCl into cation and anion, it will be H plus and Cl minus. So its valency is only 1, so its equivalent weight will be 36.5 only. Now again, the same is the case with NaOH also. NaOH is divided into Na plus OH minus, so its valency is 1. Molecular weight of NaOH is 1 into atomic weight of sodium plus 1 into atomic weight of oxygen plus 1 into atomic weight of hydrogen. So it will become 40. And equivalent weight is equal to molecular weight divided by valency. So it will be 40 divided by 1, which is equal to 40. So in common terms, we can say that the compound which is having valency 1, in all these cases, the equivalent weight will always be equal to the molecular weight of the compound. So if any compound is having valency 1, then no need to calculate the equivalent weight, just take the molecular weight as its equivalent weight. Now the third case, that is sodium carbonate. In case of sodium carbonate, if we divide this in ions, we will get 2 Na plus and 1 CO3 minus 2. Again, I am telling, if we divide Na to CO3 into ions, it will be 2 Na plus and 1 CO3 minus 2. So its valency will be 2. And its molecular weight, that is equal to 2 into atomic weight of sodium plus 1 into atomic weight of carbon plus 3 into atomic weight of oxygen. So it will be 106. And its valency is 2. So equivalent weight will be equal to 106 by 2. So it will be 53. Here are another example. First is the example of phosphoric acid, H3PO4. So if we divide this H3PO4 into its ions, it will be 3H plus and 1PO4 minus 3. So the equivalent weight, which is equal to molecular weight divided by valency, and if we calculate the molecular weight of H3PO4, it will be 3 into atomic weight of hydrogen plus 1 into atomic weight of phosphorus plus 4 into atomic weight of oxygen, which is equal to 98, and equivalent weight equal to molecular weight divided by valency, so it will be 32.6. Same is the case with calcium chloride, that is CaCl2. If you divide this CaCl2 into different ions, it will become Ca plus 2 and 2Cl minus 1. Again, I am repeating. If we divide CaCl2 into ions, it will become 1 Ca plus 2 and 2 Cl minus 1. So here also valency of this component is 2 and molecular weight of this component is 111. So 111 divided by 2 will be equal to 55.5. So we can say equivalent weight is the half of its molecular weight in case of the components which are having valency 2. Same way, you can calculate equivalent weight for FeCl3, that is ferric chloride, then Al2SO4 thrice, that is aluminum sulfate, and KMnO4, that is potassium permanganate. Okay, next. So here we will calculate the normality and molarity. So we will see an example. For example, I am reading the title or statement. 98 grams of sulfuric acid H2SO4 are dissolved in water to prepare 1 liter of solution. Find normality and molarity of solution. So here what we are doing, we are dissolving 98 gram of sulfuric acid in water. So first of all, what is our solute? Sulfuric acid is our solute. What is our solvent? Water is our solvent. And what is our solution? So when this sulfuric acid is mixed in water, it will become our solution. So what is the quantity of sulfuric acid? It is 98 gram. And what is the quantity? And what is the quantity of water? It is 1 liter. So if we convert this into equivalent weight, we know that equivalent weight of sulfuric acid is 49. But The formula of normality is gram equivalent of H2SO4 divided by volume of solution in liter. So gram equivalent of H2SO4 will be equal to molecular weight of the H2SO4 divided by the equivalent weight of H2SO4. Now molecular weight of H2SO4 is 98 and equivalent weight of H2SO4 is 49. So gram equivalent will be equal to 2. So normality will be equal to 2 divided by volume of solution in liter. Now the volume of solution in liter is 1. So normality will become 2 by 1 equal to 2. Now to calculate molarity of the solution, we need to calculate first the mole of the solute. So to calculate the mole of the solute, that is mole of the H2SO4, we need to convert the grams of the sulfuric acid into moles of the sulfuric acid. So in previous lecture, we discussed about this thing, that how to convert grams into moles and moles into grams. As we know that we have 98 gram of sulfuric acid and the molecular weight of sulfuric acid is also 98. So ultimately we have 1 mole of sulfuric acid. So the upper part of the formula is known to us, it is 1 mole of H2SO4 is 1, and the volume of solution in liter is also 1. It is given in statement that we are preparing 1 liter of solution. So 1 by 1, that is equal to 1. So finally we calculated that normality is equal to 2 and molarity is equal to 1. In case if you are dissolving 98 gram of sulfuric acid into 1 liter of water. Okay. In this example, find grams of HCl needed to prepare 1 liter 2 normal HCl solution. So our aim is to prepare 2 normal HCl solution. So the concentration in terms of normality is given to us, that is 2 normality, and the volume of the solution is also given to us, that we need to prepare 1 liter of solution. So volume of the solution will become 1, and we need to find how much grams of HCl we need to dissolve in water. So in previous case, grams of solute were given, and in this case the normality or the concentration of the solution is given, and we need to find out the grams of HCl needed. So again we will take our basic formula of normality, that is normality equal to gram equivalent of HCl divided by volume of solution in liter. Now in this case normality is known to us, that is equal to 2, and volume of solution in liter is also known to us, that is equal to 1. So we will find that equivalence of HCl will be equal to 2 gram equivalent. Now the formula for equivalent weight of HCl is equal to molecular weight of HCl divided by valency, as we previously discussed. And in this case, HCl is having valency of 1. So as I told earlier, when the valency of any compound is 1, then you can directly take molecular weight of that component equal to equivalent weight of that component. So the molecular weight is 36, so equivalent weight is also 36.5. so the weight of the HCl will be equivalent weight of HCl will be 2 into 36.5, that is equal to 73 gram. So we need to dissolve 73 gram of HCl in 1 liter of water to make 2 normal HCl solution. I hope all these things are understood. So in this lecture, we discussed about the measurement of concentration in terms of 3 different units. The first one was normality, the second one was molarity, and the third one is molality. Before that, we also discussed molecular weight and equivalent weight of the compound, and valency, how to calculate the valency of the compound. I hope all these things are understood. Thank you.